the map they just tied against Infused on, isn't it? I believe they did, and actually Infused, even I've heard, even sort of halfway through the last round, so actually Infused were going to maybe win that game. So I have no idea what to make of it. I think we're just going to have to sit back and learn and enjoy this a little bit. It's going to be NIP starting on the CT side, and will be iBUYPOWER, the American team, starting on the terrorist side here on Inferno, and they're already moving up. Forrest is going to spot a couple of people down at the bottom of Banana and looking for a quick shot with their USPS, and they're challenging him, which I think is a very, very bad idea, but they will get the opening frag, and now Freiburg falling back here, a pretty good start for iBUYPOWER.
Yeah, downing Forrest is exactly what the doctor ordered for the American team. Build a little bit of confidence, and we'll see whether they can follow that one up. AZK takes a few hits from Fiflaren, but Fiflaren retreats, and iBUYPOWER still with a full complement of players, with NIP thinking of going over towards the A site.
They've actually been keeping the bomb over there for quite a while. I'm wondering if they were hoping that someone from NIP was going to go aggressive and maybe try and take a Peter out of the apartment so they can get that kill too. But NIP have done a pretty good job just taking it slowly right now. They're going to actually double fake it and go back towards the B bomb side instead, leaving one guy in archway and dazed. It's going to open up the kill and assist. This is a huge kill. Now Freiburg stuck in, stuck in CT spawn just waiting. And over at the B bomb side, toss point, it's just going to be Freiburg on low health.
Yeah, interesting move here, and they'll move it back, and from iBUYPOWER this is great. They've not had to make a commitment yet, and they've been able to stay together and pick up frags. There's the third, it's Steele who gets get right, and NIP are 2-on-5 with a man isolated in that site. AZK's isolated Freiburg over on B, leaving just Fiflaren 1-on-5, and here we go, he's not going to get it. A 5-man clean sweep pistol win for iBUYPOWER.
And this was actually a fake on quite a high level. So the first they go and they put some pressure on Banana, and they're hoping to force some sort of rotation. They have the bomb still at the A bomb side. Then they start moving a little bit up, and then they fall back towards the B, then back to A again. So there's a lot of mind games going on here. I think that's a pistol round worthy of some analysis. Just someone should go back and make a video of that one on itself, because that was really cool.
They flip-flop from right to left on the map, but important there, and for iBUYPOWER, suddenly the confidence will return. The memories of the Infused game might be washed away, and I am reliably informed that the only reason Infused did so well in that was because Huds G just rolled back the years to a 2007 vintage, he said.
Well, I'm going to look forward to just seeing that game, maybe if I can find a demo of it somewhere, because that's going to be worthy of it, because everyone was expecting Infused to be the one team definitely going out. And actually, if someone had asked me beforehand, I would have said NIP going out first in the group and iBUYPOWER second. I actually would have put Fnatic and Epsilon below even. So I'm just very surprised. Now, a cool position come back from Forrest. We've seen this a couple of times, and I'm pretty sure iBUYPOWER know it as well, but, you know, in the pressure of the situation, they can forget to check it, and if they do, things are going to be really bad. He's the only one holding, though, so that's obviously a big problem, and he doesn't have a defuse kit, so he's not looking to go for any kind of ninja defuse here.
It'll be Skadoodle who leads the assault. He doesn't know he's there. On board with Forrest, and Forrest just went straight at it. It wasn't subtle at all. It's like, oh, there's something to shoot at. I'll shoot it. And iBUYPOWER pick up the opening. 3 frags, and look to get this one cleanly. NIP, a round and a half in, have not got a kill on the board yet.
No, they haven't, and they actually invested quite heavily into this round as well. They did buy armor and also pistols, so that means they were really looking to do a lot more than they did currently. And I'm a little bit confused about what they were doing then, because having Forrest like that, you can almost be sure they're going to check, because iBUYPOWER had no pressure on them not to check everywhere. There was no shooting from any other angle. They could focus on whatever they felt like, so I thought at least NIP could have kept one more person over there to try and distract, and maybe the American team would have been looking somewhere else.
Yeah, quite right. There was nothing to make them make a mistake at that point. So 2-0, iBUYPOWER. NIP will look to get their first frag of the game.
I was going to say, they haven't killed anyone yet. That's definitely unusual. Going into the third round here, and iBUYPOWER are going to be in a pretty cool spot. And they're also on the less favored side, so getting this kind of start is going to be huge. And the big problem for NIP is once we get into the next round, assuming they don't upset this one and come right back into it, they're going to have to win, otherwise they will absolutely be forced to eco.
Yeah. No pressure from NIP. They've not sent anyone down middle or Banana to scout out any information. They're quite happy to let iBUYPOWER come to them at this round, and iBUYPOWER will somewhat replicate the pistol round. They'll sit and they'll wait and they'll see whether they can get themselves a pick, and then they'll make their decision from there based off where they move NIP players. Get right down. And iBUYPOWER help. make the move up the middle.
Now, they actually Molotov that corner, which makes me really happy. And NIP have gone for another strange boost, this time in the A-bomb site. And I would be surprised once again if the American team hasn't seen this before. So, Exist, if he gets a kill, it's great. But look at this, they're already spotting. So, very, very intelligent play coming up from iBUYPOWER. And actually, they're being allowed to play at the pace that they want to play at right now. NIP are still not putting any pressure on them. We could be seeing three rounds in a row here without a single kill for the Swedish team.
Now, there is also, and yeah, not a single kill. Let's highlight that. How often do you see that from NIP? Interesting point, though, on iBUYPOWER that you can analyze. You know, when in football, when a small team plays a big team, the small team always overperforms where they're at because they've done that much preparation, they're that much more focused of it, and then the next week they'll slip up against a team even smaller than them. You could almost say that iBUYPOWER, and definitely Steel, he's been dreaming about this game, yeah. You know, all week, month long. And against Infused, maybe just took his eye off the ball.
I mean, interesting about Steel as well, now that you point him out, he's actually, you know, he used to live here in the UK and played for a lot of the UK teams, so I wouldn't be surprised if he's a little bit more used to the European style and can actually help out with some calling. But now we're straight into the fourth round, and this is a must-win round for the Swedish Ninjas. They gotta pick it up here. Skadoodle, great pickoff here for Flown, trying to fall back. And this is obviously not the opening they need, but Get Right with some incredible spray. Takes down Steel and ACK, and it's going to be a 4-on-3 here. In the middle, the bomb is dropped as well. Get Right just needs someone to flash him in, and he can go for a second peek, and the backup is coming. They're going to force him out with a Molotov again, and Dazed picks up two sick kills, and it's going to be a 2-on-3.
Awesome play from Dazed there, as he dispatched of Get Right. You almost thought Get Right, despite the Molotov, could get the frag. As Fifth Laren and Forrest still fully healthed and dangerous, will go up against three. They need Skadoodle's AWP to help open up the site, and he's not in this attack, as it will be for Flaren to come through. Skadoodle now getting there. They've finally got that third man in, and Skadoodle will be tasked with pushing away Forrest as that flash helps him out as well. Fifflaren will go through, and the three players still bunched up a little bit. Fifflaren gets the first, Forrest gets the second, and that will be that. And the 3-on-2, the three never looked like winning it.
No, they didn't, interestingly, and actually got a credit for Flaren quite a bit with the way he played that box position, because the way the Valve changed this bomb site, now you can spam through that wooden box in the middle, and the mistake that we've seen so much in the change is that people just hide behind it and wait. But if Flaren actually used it against iBUYPOWER, he sidestepped it a little bit and waited for them to spray through, and then he went back and tried to get the kill. So that's actually a very smart play. Good adjustment from Flaren, and that makes it 3-1, and a round that it looked like iBUYPOWER was going to win again.
Skadoodle, who did play very well in that round. Dazed gets himself a good frag, but is returned the favor by Forrest, who picks him off. AZK has dropped Forrest, and we're going tit for tat in this round. It ends in favor of iBUYPOWER. They're a man to the good. And they will quite happily sit back and see what will come next.
They're really, Get Right, this is a smart idea. If they were going to boost up and he could pick up this kill, it'd be an instant equalizer. So it's a very, very bright idea, but I'm not sure they were going to get anything from it. And the American team doing what they should be doing at this point. They got the man advantage. They're waiting to see if NIP is going to try and reclaim the advantage by peeking a little bit too much. And there it is. Swag goes for the kill, and Exist will take him down. And I am actually really confused about why he chose to do that. Because they could have left him in the apartments, and now, you know, Get Right's going to be alone. If he picks up a kill here, it's going to be great. There's the headshot. Goes for a second one. It's now 3-on-2, and Skadoodle will take him down.
Bomb going down here, courtesy of Steel. Skadoodle's AWP dispatches a Fifth Laren, and it's 1-on-2. Exist to try and save the round against two fully healthed iBUYPOWER players. Will Exist decide to go for this, or will he try and keep a weapon? That's going to be, it's a tough retake, but with Exist, you never know what he's going to deliver. And in the end, it is Skadoodle who's having a stormer with that AWP. He's up to three frags in that round, had two in the one before, and AZK as well is on 7.
Very interesting. And 4-1, and you know, one round win is not enough for NIP to build up any kind of economy, so they're going to be ecoing straight away. It's a real pleasure to see Skadoodle up at this level, because I think he's one of the really, I don't know if he's underrated, I think we actually all know how good he is, but because he's in the American team and we always end up talking about the European AWPers, we actually just forget him when we do the listing a lot, and he is very good, so that's a little bit unfortunate. But we get to see him in the action right here, maybe we can remember him a little bit in the future. Obviously nothing is set and done at this point, but NIP, the pressure is on, and the big problem is that even in the next roundup, Stuart, they're not going to have that much money.
And if you're just joining us, to understand the intensity of this game, it is must win for both teams. And they are both staring elimination AZK gets himself the frag onto Exist. It'll push in. Steel is trying to chase down. I think it's Exist who's behind him. No, it's Forrest who's got 1 point of health. And if they get... Housey's still alive. Daze is going to go through. And they will surely convert this eco out. So, yeah. They both must win. It's not all done if they were to lose this game because they still both have another match. But they can take nothing for granted. Right now, NIP are fourth and would qualify. Yeah. iBUYPOWER sit right behind them and would leapfrog them with a win.
It's a very, very strange group again. I mean, it's gone completely opposite to what everyone was expecting, and this is no different. iBUYPOWER now 5-1.
I'm not sure if Steel is happy or sad that they're winning 5-1.
I think he is excited. I think maybe guardedly excited. You know, you don't want to celebrate too soon. But I definitely think iBUYPOWER are going to be psyched if they can win this one. Moving into the seventh round, there's actually still the AWP on Skadoodle, and NIP force it up. See, this is what I was talking about. They just don't have the money for it. 3 for Masters here, no defuse kits either. If iBUYPOWER get into a bomb site and put the bomb down, it's going to be terrifying, basically, for the Swedish team.
Interesting boost onto Skadoodle that this time bore no fruit. But that at least does not cost him his life either. Freiburg will spot call the nades incoming as they will poke up the banana walkway.
Freiburg, he's the king of banana. You really don't want to challenge him. And he's up on the cart here, which is a really cool position. Hard to grenade, and he can cover a lot of that site. Now in the middle, it's going to be Getright. Molotov in the corner, they're going to peek behind it once again. Getright's ready for it. But for Mars, it's just not the right weapon for it. Steel drops down to half, and Getright takes about as much damage as well. Exist boosted up on the canopy here. It's going to take down Dazed. Mid-air headshot. Second one as well, and that's Getright picking up 2 kills. It's going to be down to Skadoodle alone here in a 1-on-5. A great round from NIP. Skadoodle with a really quick shot. Goes for a second one, but he's being spammed through. And I think Getright secured that round for the Swedes.
Absolutely. The crossfire they had on the mid was exceptional. Skadoodle's goal was to get a kill and the bomb, and then he could maybe make a play. But it wasn't to be for him. NIP get their second round in a row. Interesting to look at the role Getright has played in the 7 rounds we've had so far. Of the gun rounds that they've had, 2 he's been in the middle, 1 he's been over at B, and he's floating quite happily at the moment. This is the type of game that would suit him if the scoreline were different.
Yeah, I absolutely think you're right. This is going to be such a hard battle for NIP, especially in the next, you know, this round and the next 2, because they really don't have any kind of economy. It's good that they run the last round with 4 people alive. That builds a bit of a foundation, but they need a lot more. And iBUYPOWER, I think their economy is a lot healthier at the moment. If you flare and flash, it's going to peek right away. Actually, does get the kill on Ace on Dace. Sorry, that's impressive. Thought he was going to go down immediately.
If Flaren is buoyed by that, screams come. If you will, get right in the middle this time, and iBUYPOWER decide that they just don't have any information at that point. They got the one guy who peeked out, got killed, and they know nothing of the A site, they know nothing of the B site. They are slowly irking their way around, but Getright will retreat after spamming in towards the smoke, and iBUYPOWER just need a little information going into their own attack because they don't know where to go.
You don't. NIP with a very passive setup. Apart from Forrest here, he's a little bit far out, but I'm wondering, yeah, he's going to get flashed, and you can see Freiburg there with the flash ready, so that's going to be a pop on out to Banana, and they're not going to catch anyone just yet, but if they wait a couple of seconds, and they won't, they really can't know what we know, obviously, but that's a really good idea from NIP, though Skadoodle is going to open up the map once again, but look at that time toss bot, 25 seconds.
Not long left, as the Americans will move the bomb in. They waited for the rotation, and it's just come now from Freiburg. He's just made the commitment. No, he hasn't. He's going to come back in, and he will join Forrest on the B site to defend. Steel gets the first. Freiburg gets the second, and that's beautiful play from Freiburg. It would have lost them the round because the bomb would have gone down afterwards, and that leaves Skadoodle and Swag completely out of the game with 2 seconds to go. And and Freiburg, such a clutch double frag.
I mean, normally we counsel against people running through smokes like that because it can be absolute suicide. But he flashed his way in and managed to pick it up. And you're right, that was just the time that worked against iBUYPOWER. Very, very cool play from Freiburg. That brings it back to a 5-3 scoreline. And actually, the American team, look at this. They buy 2 AKs, 1 AWP, which tells a lot about how much they really value this weapon on Skadoodle. And then 2 pistols instead. They've used their whole bank on this one round.
Well, the interesting thing was getting away with those 2 weapons that they had at the end of that last round put them in this tough situation of we might lose them if we have to save out. So let's do this half-hearted round.
And it's really interesting. And actually, they bought 2 Molotovs, 1 on Dazed and 1 on Steel. So That makes me wonder if they're just going to use them as they have before to clear areas. I mean, they can clear the bedroom and they can clear the ninja corner down towards archway, so maybe that's what's going on. But I completely forgot about the fact that they saved those. Of course that's what happened. Now, NIP going with the exact same setup for, I think, the ninth round in a row. They've been doing this all game long.
Get right. He's ready to play his role as he edges in towards that.
Looking through the smoke.
There is Forrest now going to see action coming up towards him on B. There are four players there, only one over at A. As iBUYPOWER ready to make their push, Forrest is going to see Steel first, and he pushes out, and he is going to get dropped by Steel. Oh, didn't know whether he was coming or going there. Forrest was just shooting at anything, and that leaves Freiburg 1-on-4 here on that B site. Can Freiburg deliver here? Looks like he'll buy a few seconds.
Gonna have to do really well in this corner. If he goes down, that's a big problem. But Getright's actually already moved in. Really quick rotation. Freiburg and Getright doing incredible work. Great double kill. That's gonna be a triple from Freiburg. And now Swag is alone here, and he's gonna go down. That's Getright picking up the double. That rotation was so quick, and iBUYPOWER hesitating a lot more than they should have. If they had gone straight away, I venture to say they would have picked up that kill on Freiburg.
So I'm gonna quote Anders quoting nothing.
Oh.
So when you were casting earlier in the NIP NIP game, you said that nothing stated that you have to force a situation rather than sit and be passive. And that's what Getright did. The moment he knew he was in the position, they didn't wait for them to come onto him. Getright was just like, sod it, I'm going to go and get the kills. And that's what left iBUYPOWER thinking, oh crap, not only are they here, they're shooting at us.
That round could have gone horribly wrong for NIP as well, because Forrest, I think he was overcome by what we sometimes refer to as the I want all the kills syndrome, where, you know, you have the opportunity to pick up two or three or four kills, and instead you do absolutely nothing, because you're sort of halfway shooting at everyone, and that's really not a good strategy. So that could have been really painful.
It will be Forrest to have that opportunity once again. Now, this time against a fully saved iBUYPOWER, Freiburg is the one who will get three, Forrest gets two, and the scores are level.
I mean, things were looking very bad for NIP, but they've won five rounds in a row here, and we've gone from having, I mean, what, there's the first three rounds where NIP had picked up exactly zero kills combined. Nobody killed anyone, so this is a big change for the NIP team, and iBUYPOWER, I think if they can go out of this first half with six or more rounds on the T side, they're going to be in a pretty comfortable position. So actually, I think it's on NIP at this point to just clear out this with the rest of this half, and maybe they can.
Key moments that have won NIP those five rounds have come from Getright and Freiburg. Both have contributed to those in immeasurable ways. How many times have we said that over the years?
It's been said a fair few times, right? And it's kind of interesting to see Getright step it up and play better and better, because he's sort of on a personal level been playing a little bit under his normal level, so it's nice to see him step it up. If he's going to be back and playing at full level, then who knows what NIP can do in this tournament. Getright comes out, incredible spray, and actually a team kill from Fuflarin. That's a big problem now. That's going to lose them a lot of money, and obviously they lose Getright in the mix too.
But right on cue, Getright just going against the odds, getting those two kills, and leaving Skadoodle with only 23 points of health as well. Freiburg frags Swag, and now it will be AZK left on his own, gets himself the one onto Freiburg, but is 1-on-3, gets the second. Oh, AZK ready to go big, but was stopped at the last, and that will be NIP in the lead now.
Yeah, and actually I said the money would be a problem, but Fuflarin still started this round with about 9,000, and there's also 11,000 on Exist, which means iBUYPOWER are not just up against a really well-functioning NIP team that's all of a sudden stepped it up, but now they're also up against having to win consecutive rounds to force any kind of eco, and I'm not sure if the American team has it, especially not this round, because they've actually forced it up with, two smokes and one grenade. That's really not a lot to make any kind of play happen on the T side here.
No, you feel it with that armament, a rush up B might have been the only thing they could do to quickly get movement out of NIP, but that hasn't happened either. They do retain those nades.
They can smoke off towards quad, or they can smoke off one side of the bomb site and go for the other one if that's what they're looking for, but they really don't have a lot of options. Like, faking and everything else is out the window when you only have these few grenades. And Fuflarin is right here, gonna peek. Grenade comes in to check the corner, and iBUYPOWER are really being careful. They're realizing that NIP really do like that corner, so they're making sure they check it with grenades, which is a good idea. But nothing happening yet apart from that.
Flaren is the one he'll see action first. It's AZK, and he will get the better of him. It's going to be Fifflaren and 5 points of health against Dazed, who does dispatch a Freiburg and gets himself the second. Good work from him. And get right in the bomb site. Will go down to the hat-trick frag of Dazed. Swag has got one more, and Steel will put in the bomb, and it's all on Forrest to deliver here. 1 versus 4.
Absolutely brilliant play from Daze, jumping past the library and then actually instantly checking behind him towards the archway. That was very, very, I mean, incredibly keen game sense coming out, and that won him. Even if he hadn't got the kill on Getright at the end in the bomb site, it would have been enough what he did to Fifflaren and the guy coming out of archway. So now Forrest looking for exit kills, but he's not even going to get any. So this is a really, really big round. Luckily for NIP, as we said earlier, they have money to buy in the upcoming round. And I don't think they can lose any more rounds right now.
But they get away with 4 AKs. Forrest could have played a big role there. If he'd made that just 2 AKs or something, you're looking at 3 rebuys. But only one guy to rebuy and a bomb plant round.
This is such a close game right now, and it's really hard to know how it's gonna all play out. Because NIP are definitely good at playing the terrorist side of Inferno, so they can make some crazy comebacks. We've seen that in the past.
3 rounds left in this half. iBUYPOWER doing themselves proud in what is a must-win game for both sides, as NIP sit fourth and iBUYPOWER sit fifth in the group. Top four go through. Freiburg pushes down towards Banana and assassinates Skadoodle. AZK, though, will return the favor with two of his own. Forrest did get that, and Swag is going to tail in, and so we're on 3-on-3 now.
They have rotated towards the B bomb site. This time, iBUYPOWER a lot faster. In the previous rounds, they haven't committed when they've got that opening, but this time they're doing it. And NIP, well, they're going to make the rotation in here, but the bomb is already down, and they have some grenades. Look at how much is on iBUYPOWER. The two Molotovs is going to play a huge role here, and the smoke. This is going to be so tough. Fifflaren goes down, and now it's a 2-on-3 retake. NIP cannot lose this round, but the bomb is already ticking away. Great shot from Exist. It's going to be in the back. Dazed goes down. Steel coming up from behind. The bomb, is he going to be able to get it? Oh, Getright gets the shot, but I'm not sure there's enough time here. Just in the last second, he gets it. All right, a sick retake coming up from NIP. And actually, Steel was trying to flank all the way around, which was a great idea. But Geraint had the presence of mind to wait a second, kill him, and then defuse.
And you called out those nades, those Molotovs. They didn't get used.
No.
The Steel tossed in the flash, despite having the Molotov. So, yeah, odd round there from iBUYPOWER. Definitely one that was theirs to lose, and they lost it. But a great retake. Take nothing away from that. A great retake from NIP. And they find themselves around to the good as Exist will fire into the smoke and was not too far away from a kill he didn't know anything about. Freiburg's lost 76 points of health in the mix of things, as iBUYPOWER have got a full complement of weapons and nades in this round, barring Steel, but that's fine. If 4 weapons and 1, if they were to lose the first man, Steel's going to be there anyway, so this is an important round from iBUYPOWER's perspective.
It definitely is. Moving into the last stages of this first half, and they can win one more round. I'm not even sure NIP is going to have that much money, so it's going to be really tricky. This really tips the scale in either direction, I think. 9-6 would be a reasonable half for NIP. I think they can definitely win the game from that platform, but if they lose many more rounds, I'm not so sure. Getright in the middle, already spotting a couple of people. And it is interesting to see Exist picking up the AWP. Not the first time, but obviously he's not the go-to operator. You know, you'd have Fifflaren and then Forrest and then maybe someone else.
That's maybe one of Exist's biggest talents, that he is a multitasker. He is someone with many a talent. So we'll see. iBUYPOWER, they were attempting to try and force an agenda, and they haven't had one, so they've defected back to going in towards B. It's Forrest that'll see action first, as Freiburg's been flashed and assaulted by Dazed. And now Fifflaren is going to be the one to come up Banana. Bomb will go down. Forrest shows his head. Oh, Forrest dispatches of two heads. Steels and Dazed both down, and Forrest will take the hat-trick. And it is absolute vintage Forrest as he clears out that B bomb site.
I don't know, Forrest discovering whole new levels of absurdness when he actually doesn't reload his rifle. It's an M4A1, it only has 20 bullets. You already killed 2 people with headshots, and you choose to save the last 3 bullets for the next guy coming around the corner.
That much confidence.
That is really crazy.
8-6. Another round where iBUYPOWER will have felt, oh, we could have won that one.
absolutely could have won that one, probably should have won that one. And I like the fact that this time, last time when Freiburg came through the smoke, he killed them. This time they decided, all right, we're going to meet Freiburg on the other side. And it worked. So that should have been the opening for the American team. Now it's the last round, and all they have is body armor and pistols here. And Exist has picked up an auto sniper instead. So when the AWP doesn't work, he's just picking up the one, he's one-upping himself.
This is more natural Exist with that auto sniper. His get right will get himself the frags onto Steel, Swags, Godoodles down, and only ACK can answer back with his CZ. For NIP though, finish this one out at 9-6 at halftime. And that'll be, if I'm an iBUYPOWER fan, I'm so frustrated.
Yeah.
Because there were opportunities there for them to close out that half and potentially go in the front.
I absolutely agree. I mean, this could have been 9-6 or even 10-5, I think, in favor of iBUYPOWER instead of the other way. So definitely not an ideal situation. And what's really interesting, just to point this out, and not to assign any kind of blame, but Swag at the bottom of the scoreboard, and this kid is an absolute genius in Counter-Strike, so definitely playing way below his level. And it could be the fact that we're on the main stage, and we're in a different country. He's far relocated from his own home and his own comfort zone. So I could be playing a role here, but definitely if Swag turns this up, he can help win the game for iBUYPOWER.
Well, he was a big player at Katowice, so he is used to this type of scenario. Another one to point out on that Skadoodle. We called out when he got those six frags. They all came in the first five rounds.
Yeah.
So for the remaining 10, he didn't contribute.
So an interesting switch up. Good luck, have fun has been called, and we're straight into the second half here. So welcome to the show once again. Remember to go invite your friends, tell them to come and join us here at the Gfinity stream, and also remember to check out the Gfinity website, that's gfinity.net, so definitely go and give them some support over there. Now, Tosspot, here it comes.
Steel is lying in wait for them as the push will go. It's going to be Daze and AZK to get the first three. Oh, beautiful play from him. Swag follows up, gets himself one. That leaves Fifth Laren and 74 points of health against three. And from here, iBUYPOWER must deliver. The bomb will go down and they'll sit back and let that happen. Let that money go to NIP. And despite having the three, they weren't confident enough about it. Pushes in now. Fifth Laren gets the first. Oh, and he almost got the second. I don't believe it. But bomb down from NIP. Given they were in a 1-on-3, that's the best that they could hope for.
Yeah, I definitely think so. And you can tell that Skadoodle wanted to go for that 1-on-1 versus Reflaren. And I bet you Dazed was on the microphone just shouting at him, do not even try it. Because if Reflaren wins that one and puts the bomb down, and he would have time to do both, he could have still put the bomb down after he had killed Skadoodle maybe. That would have been a 1-on-2 that Reflaren can definitely win. So, yeah, giving out the bomb plan is definitely annoying because, for one thing, it means that NIP are going to be able to buy in the upcoming round. So it's not for nothing, but I still feel like that's the right move.
iBUYPOWER, two rounds down, but with weapons this time around.
And look at NIP. This is something I've really come to like from a lot of the Swedish teams. They start buying a lot of, no armor here, but a lot of grenades, and it doesn't stop them from buying the next round, but it means they have a real chance of winning. One good flashbang here on Dazed or his teammate in the bomb site could be enough.
So, there it is, exactly what you called us. Dazed will steal, it'll be Steel who gets action. He gets one, two, he'll look for the rest, and Dazed now will poke out, and between the two of them, they will mop up five frags, so this is the big round.
Yeah, but what if Steel had been holding, instead of inside the bomb site, he had been holding towards the CT spawn, and Dazed had been the one up on the coils? That flashbang would have worked brilliantly, so it shows you still a little bit of what it's worth. Now NIP are going to pick up the rifles here. They still have four smokes, which is perfectly reasonable, and they're going to be moving into the next round. Skadoodle with the AWP. Let's see if he can pick up that form he had on the terrorist side.
Need a big round from Skadoodle here as he will push out towards the banana walkway, sees nothing. We'll report that out to the team, that he doesn't know anything at this stage.
Hasn't seen anyone, but this is really good because actually what it will do is ultimately it will allow iBUYPOWER to leave him over there and put four people in the A-bomb site, which is a very standard setup, something that we've seen so often, but it does really work well. I mean, it's going to make it harder for NIP to go for the A-bomb site anyway.
Now, if they walk into this, AZK and Dazed have got a beautiful crossfire that they can lay down, and it will be Forrest who should be the first to see this. It's going to be the A push, and there's the first frag, and he needs that reinforcement. AZK went firing, but there was no reinforcement from Dazed, and Dazed now is going to have to make amends. Gets himself a headshot onto, gets himself a kill onto Getright, and NIP will be a man down.
Very least, they need to put the bomb down, and let's see if Forrest is going to be the man for the job. No, Dazed will take him down. That's now a double for the in-game leader here for the American team. Freiburg in a one-on-3. 35 seconds left, and he's being wrapped around. Steel will take him down, and it's going to be 9-9, moving straight into the next round, and NIP cannot buy once again. The bomb plant here, an $800 bonus. Actually, all they would have been Galil's anyway, so economically speaking, they're under great pressure right now.
And slowly I can hear from the other side of the room, Scoot starting to chant, USA and Canada, USA and Canada, as he is ready to fly that flag once again, because iBUYPOWER have tied the game back up. We'll be starting to feel confident.
We'll see. Maybe if they win, EG is going to pick up. Scoot's still an EG, right?
Not anymore.
You never really leave, do you?
He never emotionally.
That's what I mean. All right, well, moving into the 19th round, still in the corner here, Swag, and there's a corner semi-crossfire set up here. Swag going to pick up a couple of kills, and that's actually really important. Even though these are eco-frags and we can't even rate them too highly, I think if Swag is struggling a little bit, then getting a few rounds to just build up a little bit of confidence, that makes sense to me anyway.
Yeah.
And a triple this round.
Nice play from him. You know, I heard if everyone goes and plays CS Pro Mod, EG will pick up a team.
Are we still waiting for Alex to realize that's not going to happen?
We might be waiting a long time. 10-9, iBUYPOWER have the lead. And NIP have weapons. And this is going to be a fascinating round. And Skadoodle, as you mentioned, let's see what he's got to offer. He pushes out quickly here, and this is it. Oh, Forrest was lying in wait for him to show and needed just two bites of the cherry to drop him.
Yeah, and you would have thought Skadoodle would have had the upper hand in that one, and you can see he was even getting ready for the flick of death right there, but it just doesn't come through. So that's Forrest for you. Now they're the man up, and NIP with all this experience are not going to try and force anything. They're going to wait and see if iBUYPOWER are going to offer them another mistake. They have so much time to do it as well. Still more than a minute left on the clock, so if they can find one more kill, they're going to do that.
This is where experience and patience will really pay virtue. From iBUYPOWER, they will feel like they have to force it, they have to level it up somehow. And that's exactly going to play into NIP's hands.
If they do something right here, but actually, and iBUYPOWER have done this correctly. They have two people on the B-bomb side, which actually I'm generally not a fan of in a 4-on-3 like this, but it turns out to be the right move this time. Flash goes in, Steel with a great headshot. Freiburg is down, and now he's hiding in the back and gives time for Dazed to move up here on the coil. Steel picking up one more, and there's Dazed raining down hell from above. Get Right is going to go down. That's Steel with a triple kill, and what a great rotation. What great teamwork coming out from iBUYPOWER. That shot from the back of Nubox, Steel picking up the first two kills, buys just enough time for Dazed to show up. So whatever went wrong when iBUYPOWER were playing against Infused, they have obviously corrected a little bit here, because this is now really scary. NIP have lost a lot of rounds in a row, so the consecutive round loss bonus is starting to build up for them, but they can't afford to lose many more.
Cannot emphasize exactly what you're saying about Steel's frag there. You could play it and then just hear the silence, because nothing follows that first frag for 3-4 seconds. And that is absolutely golden. First frag comes in, it's Swag that goes down, Exist has it, and Get Right will push in and avenge with another one onto Skadoodle, and Get Right is angry, and Get Right is getting his vengeance as he pushes in towards that A site, and single-handedly, NIP remind us why they are just that good.
Yeah, very nice control from Get Right. And I like the little detail about him checking the bomb site with that boost spot. Really want to make sure they don't throw anything rounds away. And that's really important, that shows you a level, a presence of mind that really is that's really hard to achieve in a tournament setting like this. Because, yeah, if you're just playing with your friends on matchmaking, it's easy enough to remember to check all the corners. But when there's this much pressure on, when you're just, you know, a few rounds away from potentially being knocked out, you start making really silly mistakes. And that could have been one of them. Obviously, we know iBUYPOWER word boost up there to begin with. But if someone had been, that is not a mistake you want to make at this point. And now NIP are hunting. Steel in the corner here. Freiburg's going to take him down. And Dazed is not going to be able to save this rifle either. That's a triple for Get Right. And they equalize the score back here. 10-11. And yeah, that's going to be, it's almost equalized, sorry.
Yeah, good work there to get those rifles out, because that's forced them to buy and drop. And it's definitely made this a win the round or be on an eco scenario.
The money for iBUYPOWER is not looking too hot either. I think if they lose a round here, they might just force it up, but Skadoodle won't have enough, so it's going to be a really tricky force and a hard decision for the Americans to make. And NIP are roughly in the same spot anyway. This next eco round is going to be absolutely massive. Whoever is going to get it, it's going to be really impactful in this game.
Get right. Angry get right.
Have they unleashed the beast?
I feel like they may have just done that. As he will... And Forrest is going to go for it. Steel is not at B for once and will make his way through. ACK gets himself the frag onto Freiburg. And what a round to go four in. Steel's been nestled in B. And this was the round when they all went A and Steel was ready and waiting for them. They get themselves three frags. Fifth Laren is only on 5 health as well. And they are both in the nest, both waiting for Steel to show and Steel to deliver. Big round from him, and that will finish off the job. A hat-trick of frags for Steel, and he is dragging iBUYPOWER over the line here. They're 12-10 up.
Yeah, and it's ACK and Steel doing the majority, and actually Days too. Those three are really carrying it home right now, and it's great to see ACK playing this well. He's a really strong player and been around for a long time in the North American global offensive scene. I remember seeing him, you know, really early 2013 as well, and doing great work. Then actually, the team he was on at that point, he was the main AWPer, so it's things have changed, but obviously he can do both, so that's great.
And you know, Steel, this player who was, you know, I'm not going to say nothing in the European scene, but he wasn't at this level when he was over in Europe. He was going to stop playing and become an observer after Katowice, and well, suddenly...
You know, it's weird, because the first time I met Steel was actually when he was observing for the Raid Core Cups that ESL were doing, and he told me, look, Anders, I really want to get back into a team. I've never been playing this good before, and I thought, you know, whatever. Like, I hear this all the time from players saying that they've never played this good before. I actually just kind of brushed it off, because you're right, he was playing in some really minor British teams that obviously were never going to have a really big impact, and now he's definitely at a much higher level, so this is really interesting. Smoke's going to go off here, iBUYPOWER trying to buy time, and they still have just actually one Molotov here, so NIP are pretty going to be able to make a breakthrough and not have to run through smokes.
We're on board with Swag, who's waiting for action now. Dazed is there as well. No real crossfire here. Previously, they've set up AZK and Dazed to just mow players down, and you see Steel over on B, as we mentioned before. Skadoodle gets himself one, but Dazed and Swag both down, and iBUYPOWER are... going to have AZK trying to hold on to that site, but Freiburg had all the time in the world to line that headshot up and duly delivered. And they're going to go for this because they know that there's low health on all of those players. There's not 100 points of health between the three NIP players. And there is fully healthed up iBUYPOWER players.
Grenade here. No, actually, Molotov down. Grenade to the other side. They're going to force him up right into the grenade. Absolute precision throw coming out there from Steel. Now it's a 2-1-2. They're going in. They're going to get the kill on Freiburg. Coming up from the apartment. Skadoodle picks up the kill. And iBUYPOWER. Is there enough time? There is. They're going to pick up the round. That little trick with the Molotov to force him one way and then the grenade, that must have landed right in his teeth. What a sick throw.
Well, just all round, that retake was perfect. You couldn't analyze and do it any better. It was, well, I was going to say sensational.
I'll definitely agree with that one. And the really, really wonderful thing is, just aside from that throw, the whole thing was set up by Skadoodle actually spotting the guy running down there. He saw him running past with the AWP, obviously communicated over. So this says a lot about what's happening on iBUYPOWER right now. Just the details, it's all about the details right now.
Here we go. Steel gets himself the frag onto Freiburg, and there's only Galil's left on that side, and AZ and... I mean, NIP are on the rocks here. If iBUYPOWER convert this, they'll be 4 rounds up, 2 away from victory.
And can we bring up the scoreboard really quickly? I'm wondering how much they have. Yeah, NIP are going to be ecoing. They'll have to force it up in order to not fight for overtime. But this is very, very huge. I mean, NIP are 3 rounds away from being knocked out of this tournament, potentially.
Well, the only thing is, in theory, if you beat NIP, you'd be expected to beat whoever you would next face. But iBUYPOWER face up next. They will be on the stage. They face Epsilon in their last game. And you've no idea what that result will be, and you've no idea what NIP versus London Conspiracy will be. So as much as it'll put iBUYPOWER above NIP and put NIP in the relegation zone, that last round of games is just unpredictable.
Swag hiding in the corner, NIP, they do sort of halfway checking, and that's not enough. Swag with a great double, converts it to a triple, and it's going to be Skadoodle to pick up the last one. So actually, yeah, that was Skadoodle and Steel coming in with the last 2 kills then. And we're at 14-10, and there's no money for NIP. But, I mean, what would you do at this point, Tosspot? Will you fight for overtime?
Well, a draw's no good. A draw's no good.
Oh, you're right, it's a draw. I keep forgetting.
Because iBUYPOWER have a draw in their Mac pocket as well. Actually, a draw would keep NIP above iBUYPOWER.
iBUYPOWER have 2 draws, right?
But NIP have that one win. And that's what keeps them above them.
All right, well.
So you've got to play, well.
The NIP are actually playing for the draw right now.
The best they can hope for. Which, this is crazy. This is absolutely crazy.
It's such a long shot. After this round, assuming they don't win this one, which is looking unlikely, they're going to have to pick up five in a row here. Freiburg missing the one deke, but Exist will not. And right around the corner, HZK is ready to mow down more people. He's actually going to know that swag going down inside the pit. I think we have one guy and that's up in the balcony, and he's going to be taking a lot of kills. HZK doing great work, and it's going to be Dazed rotating in to pick up that last one onto Exist. Now 15-10, it's match and map point time for NIP.
Five of them. Yeah, this is huge. NIP staring defeat in the face. And, well, Forrest might have all the time in the world tomorrow to play CS 1.6 reunion games, because to borrow from Thorin, and he wanted praise for that statement he gave, he's got problems in 2014.
That actually made me laugh way more than it should.
We're actually paid to not laugh at Thorin's jokes.
That's very true. Sometimes hard. Skadoodle missing a crucial shot, but this is it. NIP, they want the entry frag, and they want a lot more than that here. They're setting up in a very standard position, going to try and take control of Banana. Skadoodle has missed one guy going by, so he can be crept up on. If he misses the shot on Freiburg, he's going to go down. What a sick flick. Takes down Exist all the way in the back. That was lightning fast.
That was lightning fast and maybe slightly lucky. I'm not sure he knew that one. But hey, I'm not going to take it away from him. We are ready to...
Well, what does Scoot say in this game? You make your own luck, or was it Richard?
It was Richard. He was ready to run for Prime Minister at that point. Make your own luck in this world, and iBUYPOWER have done exactly that. It's the American and Canadian dream, as they are now just four frags away, and Dazed, oh, I was about to go Axe-Lyrical. I thought he was going to land on Get Right.
Swag is going to take down Forrest. This is a 4-on-3, and things are not looking good at the moment. ACK down here trying to avoid getting flashed or smoked out. Really cool position. Going to take down one more, and it's just Get Right left here. Toss spot in the 1-on-3 is going to go down. Swag will pick up the last kill, and it'll be 16-10. iBUYPOWER winning against NIP on Inferno.
Absolutely incredible. iBUYPOWER, look at that. Look what it means to all those players. They pick up a win against NIP. Incredible stuff. And they overtake NIP to jump into fourth place in the groups, a qualifying position. And NIP are in the elimination spots. They have to beat London Conspiracy, but it is all in